Okay, so you guys do know that it's been quite some time since I did a haul video for myself. And you know what? It's just about darn time that I get me some orchids and some plants because I am definitely fiending, guys. And hubby dear has come through by getting me these early Mother's Month presents. That's right, I said Mother's Month, because here at My Orchid Adventures, we do not do the day thing. Oh no, especially when it applies to me. So we're gonna celebrate it a whole month long, and we've actually started the Mother's Month party already, folks. So yes, indeed, I'm gonna show you exactly what I got. Now, taking a look here, you see that I do have quite a lot on my plate. Unfortunately, I wish all of these were mine, but they are not. You guys know I do sell on eBay, so some of these are eBay's, and I'm definitely gonna show you which ones I selected just for me, because he indeed understands the mathematics behind a happy wife equates to a happy life. So we're gonna get this haul party started with a major bang, and this right here is one that's been on my wish list for quite some time. This is a species Cattleya, the Schilleriana, and indeed look how spectacular she is with her amazing color combination, her rippled petals right there. Oh my, so much action going on right here. And then you're seeing all of these nice speckles in the petals as well, but then you are seeing that nice combination with these very pronounced and distinctive veining right there. Look at that. Isn't she fabulous? And what's even more fabulous than this, besides her fragrance, of course, because you know that is absolutely scrumptious, but she indeed is in bud right there, having two buds left to bloom. So yes, indeed, major green thumbs up on this one, and I'm so happy and so proud to have her. And I do have to tell you, I am absolutely tickled pink with this orchid right here, or should I say tickled orange. And if we actually take a closer look at this bloom structure right here, you will see the buds in production in between the bracts, and this will actually become enlarged, and it'll throw off a multitude of these miniature orchid blooms. So indeed, this is going to give quite an incredible orchid blooming display, quite a nice structure, and looking very tropically delicious. And will you take a look at this little fella right here? Now, this guy is an encyclia, and to be specific, is an encyclia fowlii, or fowlii, however you want to pronounce that. And this has one of the most unique, amazing encyclia blooms there are. It's the only one that I know of that has very distinctive tessellation patterns in the bloom, that it is really an amazing sight to see with the abundance and multitude of blooms. Now, this little guy is only a two bulb with one growth coming up, and can you believe I paid 30 buckaroonies on this? But I will have to say I'm happy to have her, because she is not often available, so to get one in my grasp, it indeed was worth the 30 bucks. And I must forewarn you, I have just gotten bit by the bromeliad bug. Now, I do have quite a variety of bromeliads, but I never really showcased its amazing beauty and really allowed it to fully reach its potential within my garden. So I am going to designate a section of my garden, which is going to be mainly mountings of these beautiful bromeliads, but I'm also going to have them as a ground cover as well. And as a matter of fact, this week we are supposed to be going somewhere to get a multitude countless of bromeliads. As a matter of fact, a truckload full of bromeliads. So that's going to be an exciting mounting and planting adventure here in the future. So definitely stay tuned for that. So this nice size bromeliad right here, which is called the tricolor, which is very self-explanatory, as you can see with the variegation and also the splashing of color in here with that very deep magenta red, then with the striations and the stripe of the variegated pattern right here with the lovely green and also the striping of white. And this very tropical bromeliad right here, unfortunately I did lose the tag, but I do believe this is the tiger stripe. And as you can also see in the leaves, it does have that very distinctive striping pattern in here, that nice banding of green and also a silvery gray color. And take a look at the bloom. Indeed, quite unique and very tropically delicious. And both of these bromeliads are with pups. And as with the saying goes, we don't die, we multiply. And speaking of beautiful patterns within the foliage, also variegation and a tricolor effect, this one indeed has all of the charm. Now, this is not a bromeliad. This is actually a dracaena, but indeed it does have that tropical bromeliad type of effect and would also go well within my bromeliad section of the garden. And the color combination on this is something so astounding, where you can see the beautiful lime green on the edges, and in the center you are noticing the white variegated within a dark green. What a beautiful, beautiful look on this dracaena Warneckii. And here's yet another orchid that has been on my wish list like forever as well. And I actually had one of these a long time ago, but it was somewhat of a seedling size. This was back in the day where I actually entertained getting seedlings for the sake of saving money. And for me, it had not been worth my time because majority of my seedlings did not survive. So I have to tell you, to get an orchid at this size right here was quite a thrill. These leaves right here are actually at about 2 feet long. That's how absolutely huge these leaves are. Look at that. This incredible orchid is the Selogeny pandorata, also known as the black orchid for the black markings that are found within the blossoms. Speaking of amazing blooms from this pandorata right here, this will actually throw off a very long inflorescence that is cascading and very pendulous, and it can bloom up to about 15 blooms on one spike. And I have to tell you, once you see the blooms off of this Selogeny pandorata and you're capable of witnessing how amazing the color combination and the markings are of this green and black blooming orchid, it is something that you will not be able to shake, and is something that you will fall madly head over heels in love with. At least that is what happened to me. I not only wanted one of these, I needed one of these in my life. And I do have to say that this love affair has been off to quite a good start, as you can see right here with that spike that is emerging. And also, look at that, a second spike as well. So indeed, we are going to be able to witness the beauty and the charm and the boldness of this Selogeny pandorata. Now, these two pretty big size Phalaenopsis right here are actually of the same variety. They are both Phalaenopsis Sogo Eucidian. Now, these two Phalaenopsis right here are actually very popular and renowned for their very gorgeous and abundant white blooms that they give. And they bloom these exquisite large blooms on a very long, long cascading spike. And you are just going to find an abundant amount of those very large white clean and pristine and very sophisticated and elegant blooms. And both of them are very, very large and very healthy phalaenopsis. And I know you're wondering, why in the world would I get two of the same kind of phalaenopsis? Well, guess what, folks? These two right here are actually going to be test subjects for an upcoming experiment. And I've actually already named them. This one right here is called Benifer, and this one right here is called Brangelina. So please be sure to stay tuned for more. And this one right here is a Vandaceous Terete type of orchid, similar to the Miss Joaquim orchid or the Vanda Terese. And this one actually will be blooming in a white bloom, again, similar to the Miss Joaquim. And I also had the wonderful opportunity of purchasing an assortment of these Chloe's plants. And as you guys know, these plants right here are very attractive in their foliage. They expose a wide variety of different patterns and colors and textures and shapes, indeed becoming one of the most attractive foliage plants, adding quite a splash and an interest to any garden. And will you guys take a look at these variegated leaves right here coming off of the Impatience plant, which is a blooming and flowering plant, as you can see right here, with the very white pristine blooms. Definitely an attractive foliage plant as well, bringing a lot of impact to any visual display. And wowzer, folks, will you take a look at this very hefty bloomer right here. And I actually purchased a variety of these. I could not believe how many varieties of the portulaca that they do have. I've never seen them this big, to be honest with you. And the color combinations are just so fantastic and amazing. And what I love about these ones right here, they actually remind me of poppies. Just so gorgeous and breathtaking. This is the portulaca, also known as the rose moss, for its ground covering and low and very compact shape in which it grows. And of course, because of the blooms and how they do appear to have the appearance of roses. And this orchid right here is a very interesting and beautiful orchid. Now, the growth structure of this orchid right here reminds me similar to the catasetum types of orchids, as you can see with the bulbs, and they will also lose their leaves as well. So definitely is the reason why it reminds me of a catasetinae type of orchid. This orchid right here is a Chysis bractescens. Now, I will have to say that everything about these blooms right here screams gardenia to me. From the waxiness of the texture to the very pristine and beautiful snowy white, and also even down to the very lovely and very strong fragrance. Indeed, this Chysis bractescens is quite a charmer. And last but never least is this spectacular orchid right here. And if you've been following my channel for quite a while, you would know exactly what she is. This is an Encyclia curdigera, one of my most favorite orchids of them all. And I actually have one of these already, but not quite this variety right here. This is the Encyclia curdigera variable rosea. Now, these blossoms have just recently opened up about 2 days ago, so they are not at its fullest or greatest potential, but indeed, it'll give you an idea of how these blooms look. And the main difference between the regular variety and the rosea variety is the fact that the colors in here are so doggone intense. So dramatic, so bold, and so remarkable. These blooms are just so wonderfully colored and beautifully shaped. And not only that, folks, if you've ever smelled one of these, you guys know that they are intoxicatingly and very deliciously fragrant as well. So beautifully colored, so wonderfully formed, and also one of the most delicious and intoxicatingly fragrant blooms I have ever smelled. Now, I do have to tell you, I spent quite a pretty penny for this orchid right here. As a matter of fact, I spent 50 buckaroonies for this gal right here. But taking a look at her, oh my, I do not feel any type of guilt nor remorse at all. And as a matter of fact, I feel very lucky to have her. And there you have it, folks. That is my orchid and plant haul. And I have to tell you, I am feeling very blessed to have these wonderful orchids and also wonderful plants. But even more than that, folks, I am so very blessed and also very thankful to have hubby dear. Now, this is the start of our Mother's Month celebration, but the party will continue on at the Redlands Festival. So definitely I will be there and I will be looking forward to meeting all of you guys. And I do have some wonderful surprises for you guys as well. So definitely I can't wait to meet you for those that are going. And I will be there definitely for sure Saturday at 12 noon time until closing. And I may even be there Sunday as well. And definitely I am looking forward to perhaps even spending time with you guys afterwards. So definitely let me know what your plans are and we'll see if we can get together. And there you have it, folks. That is our orchid and plant haul. Please be sure to let me know exactly which ones were your favorite and definitely let me know by posting those comments below. I thank you guys so much for tuning into yet another episode of My Orchid Adventures, for allowing me to share my love, my passion, and my orchids and plants with you guys. I do hope that you guys liked this video, and if you did, please be sure to like, share, and also subscribe, and make sure you turn on that bell notification button so you guys will know exactly when I do post a new video. Also, be a dear and join me on Facebook and also Instagram at My Orchid Adventures. Thank you so much, and as you guys already know, I truly do love and appreciate each and every one of you guys all, and I will see you guys later, and I'll also grow with you guys later as well. Bye-bye. Bye for now. Mwah.